So, here's the code for my Boggle solver. Here, up here at the top, you can see the standard imports, date time, and the sys library. And then we initialize a few global variables. A list called words found that we put the words we find in. A list called my board that we use to hold the Boggle board. A list called mydict, bad name, that holds a list of strings from the dictionary, and the total number of searches tried, and then a couple global booleans, verbose and cleverness. Verbose turns on verbose output, and cleverness changes it from the strictly brute force algorithm to applying maybe a little more cleverness than brute force. Now let's start on the functions. You start with load board. It loads the board, and then it takes in a file name. We then open the file with that file name, and then read in all the lines into a list. And then for each line, we append it. We append that line of my board. We split that line of my board, and then we append it. Split that line of the internal board, and then append it to the global my board. And then we increment the index so the loop, you know, loops. And then there's print board, which prints the board letter by letter, line by line. Prints the letter, and then the print ends with a space. Then once it's done with the row, it prints an end line. And that's about all for the board functions. Now there's the move functions. Possible moves takes in coordinates and the current board and returns a set of tuples containing coordinates that would be valid moves from that coordinate given. Then we define the max for both the horizontal and vertical coordinate to be the length of the board. And then we create an empty set. We define the edges of the board, and then we check if this point is on an edge. These would be false if it was, say, on the right edge. You can't go any further right. If it's on the left edge, can't go further left. Same thing with up and down. And then if we can move up, it adds first the move directly up, then the move to the right, then the move to the left. And then it checks if we can move down, adding the move directly below, then the move down into the right, then the move down into the left. And then it checks if we can move left and right and adds move directly to the left and directly to the right, and then returns that set. Legal moves takes in a set, typically the output of possible moves, and a list of moves made from the beginning to the end, from the beginning up to now. And it takes out all the moves that have already been done, and returns a set containing the moves that are possible but haven't already been made. And then examine state. It checks if you've made a word and if the word is valid. First, we need to make the word from the history we've been given. And then so we take all the positions in history and get the letters at the board in that position, and then we take the letter at the current move. And then, because the Boggle board's all capital and the dictionary's all lowercase, we make a string lowercase. And then, we check if cleverness is true. If cleverness is true, we perform a check that checks if the current word is the prefix of any word in the dictionary. If there exists any word that, any string that starts with word in the dictionary, it's true. Otherwise, it returns false. And if cleverness is enabled, we just treat it as false so it doesn't use it as a parameter. So it doesn't try and do the cleverness step. And then we check if the word we made is already in the dictionary as its own word, by simple membership check. But there's weirdness with new lines. So word plus n, word plus backslash n. We also have to check if that's in the dictionary. And then if the word's in the dictionary with or without a new line, it returns the word, whether it's yes, the string yes, and a Boolean indicating whether or not it's a prefix to another word. Otherwise, same thing, but with the string no instead of yes. Now we're getting to the big method that actually finds words, like Boggler. It takes in the board, the current move, the previous moves made, a dictionary, and the words that have been found, and the list of all words that have been found. This starts by copying the history and adding the current move to the history. And then it finds a list of moves that would be legal from the current move. We declare the global tries variable so we can count the number in this function so we can add to it and increment it accordingly so that we can keep track of the total number of moves that have been tried. And then it takes a candidate move from the moves try list and then tries that one, gets the state that that move leaves the board in, and if verbose is enabled, it prints that move's state, prints the current move, the candidate move, the moves to try next, and then the state. And then if yes is in the move, is in the state, it adds it. If the string yes is in the move state, return from examine state, it adds the word to the list of words found. If cleverness is enabled and it is a substring and the word is a prefix of any of the words in the dictionary, then Boggler continues on the path. Otherwise, if cleverness is enabled, then it just skips this move and goes to the next one who moves to try. And if cleverness is disabled, it just keeps running until there's no more valid moves that can be made from your current move. Yeah. And this is a helper function that divides the string lists, the list of strings, by its length, so we can, in a dictionary, and then returns that dictionary. Takes for each item in the list. If an item of that length isn't already in the list, it adds that item in a singleton list to the dictionary. Otherwise, it appends the item to the list with key of the length of the item in the dictionary, and it keeps going until we run out of items in the list. And then it returns the dictionary. And now to the driver function that does all the back end and the printing and what have you. Basically, it loads the board that's given in the board name parameter, prints out the board, then it gets the time that it starts trying to actually solve the board, and then defines variables I, J, and history, and then it tries to find all words starting from the word at I, J, while I and J go up, so it touches every possible pair as a starting point. And then once it's done finding all the words that could start with it, it clears the history just so it can start another run. And then once those loops are done, it gets the time that they finished as end time. Now we remove any duplicates from the words we've already found, and then turn it back into a list so that we can sort it later. And now we display the total number of words found, then display a list of words by their total, by their lengths, the amount of time it took to run this, and the num all of the number of moves that were tested in the process, and then the alphabetical order list of all the words. And now for the main function that actually runs the program. First, we define a filename to default to if there's no filename given by the current command line. Otherwise, we get the one given by the from the command line. And then we check for the cleverness and verbose flags. And then we call driver and start the whole program. Now that's all great, but let's see, does it run? Going to call the script on a simple two board. But we're going to leave the cleverness optimization off and let it run its course. It came back quickly, tested 60 possible moves, and found 9 words: oot, wot, two, woo, and toe. And then it found three two-letter words: two, wo, and ow. All this in this little board here. And let's see it with cleverness on. It takes longer with cleverness on a board of two, on a 2x2 board, but after that, this is a 3x3 board with cleverness turned on. It took 3.85 seconds and found 40 words. To prove it's faster, I'll show you with cleverness off. Tried 322 words, found 40. And now the cleverness off. We might be here a little while. It took 24 seconds on the same board and tried 10,296 just to get the same group of results. And Now let's show you a 4x4 board. But we don't have all day, so we're gonna have to do it with cleverness. Seriously, it takes 15 hours if you don't have cleverness turned on. And it tested 1,208 and found 54 words in this board. Now I can show you the output I got last time I tried to run it without cleverness. Top run here is with cleverness turned off. It took 15 hours, 20 minutes, and 34 seconds testing 12,029,624 possible strings that can be generated, that can be found in this Boggle board, in that Boggle board. This is the same board, but with cleverness turned on. Here we have the exact same set of words, but it only took 29.13 seconds. That's ridiculously faster. Only trying 1,317 words. And to show you that it's real output, I'll run it on that board again. But with cleverness turned on, because we don't have all year. As you can see, the result is pretty much the same. Took 17 seconds. Instead of 29, I've made some optimizations since that last run, but it found the same set of words. See, found the exact same set of words every time. There we go. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you. Bye-bye.